last emergency, medical aid, overdose, East Hastings Street.
It's 50 times stronger than heroin and 100 times stronger than morphine.
Because they look similar to heroin, we can't really tell just by looking at the package itself whether or not it contains this really dangerous, deadly substance. A first responder or a lab personnel that got exposed to fentanyl would be drowsy, have a hard time breathing, their pulse rate would slow, they would be unconscious pretty quickly.
Our goal in this research was to provide a mechanism for law enforcement to determine in the field, without having to open bags and sample directly from bulk powders, that they actually have fentanyl or one of its analogs in the material.
We're looking at two different techniques, ion mobility spectrometry, which is more of a field-based screening technology, so something that police officers could potentially have in the back of a cop car or a crime scene van. Then we're also looking at DART mass spec, direct analysis and real-time mass spec, which is more of a laboratory-based technique which forensics labs can use for rapid screening of casework to determine whether certain drugs are present and how to handle those drugs.
These trace technologies have existed for many, many years and been used in other applications, including drug analysis. What we did in this research was analyze several different fentanyl analogs, things that we're seeing pop up on the streets, and we were able to see if this technology can separate those and determine all those different fentanyls.
So fentanyl is typically found at a few point percent with either heroin or a cutting agent or something else. So the question was, even at that low percentage, is it still able to detect these compounds? And we showed that even at 1,000 to 1, we're still able to readily detect the fentanyl signal.
Well, when we did this research, we were using one specific trace detector and one specific technique. I'd like to expand that to other trace detectors, other brands, other types, and continue looking at new analogs as they come out and make sure that we can capture those too.
I would think a hazmat team would be able to use an IMS if they came across a powder and they needed to know whether or not that powder could be dangerous to them.
Well, I think it could really help the law enforcement community to be able to safely detect a potential hazard and just know more in depth in a quick way what might be in that hazard.